I come from UP, Uttar Pradesh, and in the evening, in any small town, village, the older part, quarter of the city, you will find the air thick with people standing on their roofs and shouting, ow, ow, ow. And the air is, of course, full of feathers, and there you will see lots of pigeons flying in there. So these are the pigeons coming home to their dovecotes. This is kabutar bazi, and it doesn't mean that you just train your kabutars or your pigeons to go in the morning and come back in the evening. It means that when they come back in the evening, now this is where the skill of the pigeon fancier comes in, that his pigeons are guided in such a way by the master's voice, which they recognize, that they bring with them, they hijack pigeons from other people's flocks. Now the person who's pigeons have been hijacked or who have been taken kidnapped or whatever by the his rival's pigeons will then take revenge, and he will take revenge by not only getting back his own pigeon but by getting extra pigeons from his rival's flock. So it's a very serious business, and it has led to it can lead to fights, and you know, serious bets are laid. So of course nowadays all this has come down, and but in Delhi, in Shahjahanabad, you still see in the evening and in the morning, the roofs will be full of the pigeon fanciers, and the air will be full of pigeons. Now, this has given rise to many popular stories. And one very popular story is, of course, Noorjahan and Jahangir. Dekho idhar hai mehlaka, mera kabutar dusra, jaldi batao kya hua? Chhat phole pan se keh diya, सरकार वो तो उड़ गया. बोले कि है क्यों कर उड़ा, ऐसा तो हो सकता ना था. छठ दूसरी मुट्ठी जो थी कुछ मुस्कुराकर खोल दी. ये सादगी उफरे गजब, शहजादे का दिल आ गया, फिर जानते हो क्या हुआ. Now, this is, of course, a purely fictitious story of how Salim, who became Jahangir, met Mehrunnisa, Noorjahan, she was holding two pigeons, and she let one go, and then he asked, how did it fly? And she opened her fist and said, this is how he flew away, and both fly away. So, but these are stories which show the importance of pigeons, and as a metaphor also of love. Of course, this is a fictitious story, but the Mughals laid great importance on pigeons and pigeon rearing, pigeon flying. And in fact, Akbar gave it the name Ishqbazi, love play. So their relationship with pigeons was nothing new. Tariq-e-Rashidi says that on Monday, the 4th of Ramzan, Umar Sheikh Mirza, having flown from the top of the precipice with his pigeon and his pigeon house, became a falcon at the age of 39. Now, Umar Sheikh Mirza is Babur's father, and he died, fell from the top of his pigeon house while he was flying pigeons. And that led to Babur, and then his Babur coming to India and establishing the Mughal Empire. Now, as an aside, I'd like to mention that we refer to them as the Mughal emperors. They called themselves the House of Timurids because they were descended from Timur, or Gurkani because on the maternal side they were descended from Genghis Khan, and Gurkani means sons-in-law. The term Mughal, which is a Persianized word for Mongol, was not something that they liked, and it was a term that was used by the Portuguese for them. But since that is how they are known, we will also call them the Mughal emperors. Ayn-e-Akbari, which is the constitution of Akbar written by Abul Fazl, has an entire chapter on pigeon flying, and I read from there. His Majesty calls pigeon flying Ishqbazi, love play. This occupation offers the ordinary run of people a dull kind of amusement, but His Majesty, in His wisdom, makes it a study. He even uses the occupation as a way of reducing unsettled, worldly-minded men to obedience, and avails himself of it as a means productive of harmony and friendship. The amusement which His Majesty derives from the tumbling and flying of the pigeons reminds him of the ecstasy and transport of enthusiastic dervishes. He praises God for the wonders of creation. It is therefore from higher motives that he pays so much attention to this amusement. Now, of course, Abul Fazal was his official chronicler, so he attributes a lot of spiritual motives to this spot. But it was a spot, and it was taken very seriously. And what I found very interesting in this was the colors that His Majesty names the pigeons according to their colors. Now, Makhzi is fly beaten, Zirhi steel blue. His Majesty invented this name. Chini, porcelain blue. Nafti, grey like nafta. Shafaki, violet. Udi, aloe wood colored. Surmai, from the surma that we, antimony that we put in our eyes. Kishmishi, dark brown. Halwai, like a sweetmeat. Sandali, light brown, like sandalwood. And Nilofari, bluish white. Azraq, a color between yellow and brown. Then you have Shaftalu, which is the Persian word for the fruit peach. Muharraq, a dirty black. Khizri, a color between green and Udi. Udi is violet. Now, Khizr, as you know, is known popularly as the green prophet or the green man. He is the patron saint of water and of travelers. Abi, another name for a pigeon, is water. And then pigeons have names such as Gulzar, whose head resembles a flower. Dam Qaza, stump tail. Yak Rang, means of one color. Halq, Halqum Safed, Halq is throat, so white throat, and etc. So these are some lovely names that they are given. And then he goes on to talk about that there are some who don't perform, of course, Charak and Bazi, but are distinguished by their color. And then there's the Lukkan, which struts about proudly, wagging its head. Even today, there is a pigeon called Laka, which is extremely popular. And then you have the Gola. Then the Lotan Kabutar, which is the tumbler. And a lot of emphasis is given on the how they are trained, how they are bred, and what they are called, and that a pigeon does not live above 30 years, and that 4 seer of feed were given to 100 flying pigeons. Another very important function that was performed by pigeons was they were carrier pigeons. They carried letters. So Jahangir, in his memoirs, writes, talks about the Kabutar in Amavar, that it is stated that in the time of Abbasid Caliph, they taught the Baghdad pigeons, who were styled Namavars and were one half larger than the wild pigeons. So then he also tells his pigeon fanciers to teach them and how to take letters from Mandu to Burhanpur in the shortest period of time. These two cities are both in Madhya Pradesh. And he talks of the they keep on trying to reduce the time that is taken between them. So serious was this pigeon flying that there is a book written on it called Kabutar Nama, the Book of Pigeons, by Sayyid Muhammad Musafi, whose poetical name was Wali. This book work consists of a poem of 163 couplets. It's in the British Library, and followed by a short prose treatise explaining the different types of pigeons, their colors, characteristics, and the art of pigeon flying. It was written as a gesture of friendship for one Mia Huban, who asked for an elegantly written account of pigeon flying. Now, pigeon flying, as I said, pigeons are taken as an imagery for the heart. Mehve parvaz hai ye dil aur main jaan chhadakta hu is kabutar par. Kashif Hussain Khair. This heart is engrossed in flying, in love. I can sacrifice my life for this stuff. And during the time of Bahadur Shah Zafar and Akbar Shah, and maybe earlier also, but I have found accounts only of these two emperors, when pigeons were used as a signal, when the emperor would go out to the Eidgah for namaz or to the Jama Masjid, a flock of pigeons up to 200 would be released to announce his arrival. So very similar to the flypast that you see on Republic Day, where you have formations of jets and fighter planes and aeroplanes, that is the same way that kabutars were sent out when the Mughal emperors would set out of the Red Fort or the Qila-e Mubarak. It is said that Bahadur Shah had employed a person called Sayyid Waris Ali, who had trained 200 pigeons to fly in rows behind the emperor as he came out of his palace seated on his famous elephant Maula Baksh and going to the Eidgah. And these pigeons would provide shade over the emperor, and they were trained in such a way as to not let their droppings come onto either the elephant or the emperor. And you can just imagine the magnificence by just thinking of the flypast on Republic Day. when Ahmad Shahab Dali attacked Delhi, a lot of the Kabutarwaz went to Awadh. It is said that Wajid Ali Shah had 24,000 pigeons, which he was very, you know, he was very upset and saddened to leave them behind when he had to go to Calcutta in exile. And such was his love for pigeons that he had a pair of resham para, which he bought at 25,000 rupees in those days. And pigeon fanciers, of course, were called ustads. And as I said, that pigeon flying is a very serious business. And pigeons are today, they are fed on ghee and malai. And some are even given opium so that they become musk. And the pigeon coop is called the kabuk. And they're built on the roof of the houses. And the pigeons are looked after with great care. And they are really, really precious to their owners. उड़ते उड़ते कभी मासूम कबूतर कोई आपकी छत पर उतर आए तो शक करता हूँ. So not only is it used, you know, like the metaphor is that I can't go to my beloved's house, but the pigeon can. So of course I have doubts. This is by Ahmad Kamal Parvazi. And kabutarbazi in today's term, of course, it's just a shadow of its former self, but it's still a lot of fun.